ज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकय चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां नमो महावदन्याय कृष्णा प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरकिशे गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकायै तदाले कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय तदभक्ताय यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरहकात्तरया जुहाव पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तर्वोभिनेदु तं सर्वभूतहृदयं तवैवास्मि न जिमानि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे humble dandat pranam in the lotus feet of my Paramaradhyam Gurudev Srimad Bhakti Pragyan Kesava Goswami and the same in the lotus feet of my Shiksha Guru Shri Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj. First we began Uttama Bhakti, Shuddha Bhakti. And we also explained what is not Uttama Bhakti. Arop Siddha, Sangha Siddha, Sarup Siddha, so many kinds. And also again Adav Saddha, Tata Sadhu Sangha. We have explained sadhu sangha up to now anartha nivritti, then nishtha, ruchis, and so many things. So, how we can give up all anarths? We should know about Srila Raghunath Das Goswami. He is in the line of Rupanuga Vaishnava, very near and dear to Rupa Goswami, to all Vaishnava. How he took birth in a very aristocratic, wealthy family. He was only one son of his two brother father, very rich person. In boyhood, he was so fortunate to be initiated by Jadunandan Acharya in the line of Advaita Acharya. And then Krishna arranged Haridas Thakur and sent him where Raghunath Das, baby Raghunath Das was there. And always he used to be with Haridas Thakur, Raghunath Das was from baby. He has so much taste in chanting names. How fortunate was he in his, even he was a baby. In the age of 5, he received initiation from Jadunandana Acharya. Gradually developed. Haridas Thakur, only for him, he used to come to Bishai. His father was Vaishnava prayer. There are two kinds of Vaishnava. Vaishnava Praya and Bishai Praya. Bishai Praya is good. Vaishnava Praya is not good. Like Vaishnava but not Vaishnava. It seems that is Pundarik Vidyanidhi. Raya Ramananda, Srivas Pandit and all. It seems that they were Vishai. But what they were? Not pure Vaishnava. Uttam Bhagavatam. His father was serving all Vaishnavas. Haridas Thakur used to go. And so many Vaishnavas used to come to them. But he was engaged in Vishai. So he was Vaishnava Praya, not Vaishnava. So if we will think all these symptoms, we will see that we are also what? Vaishnava Praya, not Shuddha Vaishnava. Try to be like Pundarik Vidyanidhi, Raya Ramananda, Srivas Pandit, like Pacho Pandavan, Draupadi, like all. And if renounced like Narad, Sukadev, Goswami, Rupa Sanatana and others. So from beginning he was associating with Haridas Thakur, and Haridas Thakur used to go only for this baby, boy. So from beginning he became. He has so much affection for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu from beginning by hearing Jadunandana Acharya and Haridas Thakur especially and other Vaishnavas. All Vaishnavas used to come to his house. So if anyone has done some past activities like this Sukriti, though Raghunath Das Goswami eternal associates of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Radha Krishna, but he is playing like that, that we should be like that. After some time he has so much love and affection for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, always weeping when he became like 12 years or more, some. He was always thinking, where I will meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? And by the luck, fortunate, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took sannyas and he wanted to go to Vrindavan. But the tricky Nityananda Prabhu took him to Shantipur. And there he heard that, oh, very near to my village, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come. And then went there. And what became there? Always he liked to be with Mahaprabhu, his remnants. And he came one day, someone told that he is the son of that Govardhan Majumdar and he is the disciple of Jadunandan Acharya, associates of Haridas Thakur. So Mahaprabhu has some affection for him. He told that I want to be with you in where you will go. He became a boy but became mad. Not like the devotees like nowadays. They go to their Gurudev. Oh Gurudev, I want to take poison. Give me what? This poison. Gurudev says, how I can order it? Then I will suicide. I may suicide. Or don't suicide. You will have to suffer more than now. Anyhow, but Gurudev tells, I cannot give order. But this is poison. If you are not obeying me, you can take yourself. I will not give order. Oh, he was very happy and clapping that Maharaj has given, my Gurudev has given order that you can take that poison. from origin of this creation, this sense gratification and all these things we are doing. Even we have been human before, king, with so many and so many animals, hawks and pigs, or thousands of wives, demigod also. But even we are not satisfied. I know that after some time they will not be satisfied. Again there will be hog and pigs. So how Gurudev can order for this? Never. And what Raghunath Das is doing? What he is doing? Oh, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Prabhu, I want to come with you. Mahaprabhu told, don't be mad, don't be mad. Ghar jao, naho batur. Naho batur. Krame krame bhaya log bhavasindhu ko. Antare kara nishtha, lok vyavahar, achirate pabe, uddhar. What he told? The meaning.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told to Shri
try to realize all these things and hear patiently. If you want really Nityananda Prabhu mercy and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu mercy and to be happy in life, oh, very carefully you should read how we can attain the mercy of Nityananda Prabhu.
Srila Raghunath Das Goswami, although an eternal associate of Radha and Krishna, was playing the part of a conditioned soul gradually advancing in Krishna consciousness. So the first time that he went to see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he wanted to leave home and immediately be with Mahaprabhu. But Mahaprabhu told him, don't be a madman and try to leave your home prematurely. Stay at home and externally act as an ordinary person with ordinary behavior, but internally develop your Krishna consciousness. And step by step you'll advance, and gradually the time will ripen, your bhakti will mature, and then you'll be able to leave everything. Srila Raghunath Das Goswami was so advanced in his bhakti, Srila Gurudev said that now we want to go to girlfriends and boyfriends and take poison. But he explained previously that Srila Raghunath Das Goswami was so advanced that even though his wife was more beautiful than Miss Universe, he was so busy in being absorbed in Krishna that he didn't even have time to see her, and he didn't have time even to look in the mirror. He was so absorbed in bhajan. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave him that order that when the time comes, then Krishna will guide you within and you'll be able to leave everything, and he did, and he went and joined Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Thank you. Antare kara nishtha, bahye loka vyavahar, achirate Krishna tumar paribe nirbhar. What is the meaning? Nishtha. We are going to explain what is nishtha. Nishtha bhakti, or nishtha bhakti, so much. And Bandh Maharaj has given classes here and there for this. So much. We also. So, he told, antarikara nishtha. Nishtha means buddhi sthi. To steady of mind, heart. You should return back to your home. From outer, you should obey your father, mother. And do what you should do. Antare kara nishtha bahriye lok vyavahar. And outwardly, you should mix with them. Why to measure your bhakti? Until your bhakti is not somewhat come to nishtha, then you can return back again. At least nishtha and then ruchi. If ruchi come nowhere, then you cannot fall down. So if you have no nishtha, that is why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ordered him, go back to your home. Lok-vyavahar means you should do pranam to your father, mother and others, you should mix and you can do other jobs. And antar means infinity. Have nishtha in the Lord's feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, in the Lord's feet of Nityananda Prabhu. And gradually you will be developed and there is none to stop you. And if you are not in that position and you are giving up home, oh, again. What became of that? He went, returned back. And he was helping his father in what? Rajkaj?
Landlord, property.
Property and all other things. After that, but he was chanting, remembering. Oh, Nisha was inside. Developed his bhakti. And then he heard that, oh, Nityananda Prabhu has come to Saptagram. Where? Panihati. Very nearer to Saptagram. Not far away. And he heard and at once he told father that I am going to Nityananda Prabhu to meet. Krishna makes these arrangements. You cannot. If you are sincere, oh, Krishna step by step, he has arranged everything. So, when Nityananda Prabhu came there with his whole associates, then he went by the permission of his father, taking some money. His father gave that, oh, you should feed sadhus, do mahatsav and anyhow you should serve. And very soon you should return back. Oh, father, I will return. And he went there and he saw that, oh, so many sadhus, Vaishnav, with Nityananda Prabhu, thousands of Vaishnav. And on the bank of Ganges, under the shade of a banyan tree, he was sitting like sun. And all were surrounding him. He went there. At once, anyone told that, oh, Raghunath has come, the son of that person. Oh, bring him, oh, Chora. Chora means? Othi. Oh, come on, come on, come on. And he was shrine. But anyhow, so many brought him. And Nityananda Prabhu told that, I will punish you. And telling him, he gave his feet on the Lord's, on his head. Brahma, Shankar cannot have this. Never. That Nityananda Prabhu, mani Baldev, you should know. Like Krishna, in trance they cannot have, and Nityananda Prabhu gave his lotus feet on his head. And then what became? Oh, I will punish you. You should do Chida Mahotsav. Not rice.
Chip rice festival.
Chida Molita.
Chipped rice.
Chipped rice. You should bring months of yogurt, milk, sandesh, banana, and sugar, and so many things. And he brought from this village, here and there. Because thousands of devotees were there. And he ordered, he has some persons from his father house, like servants. and they went village to village and collected so much for thousands of persons. And then that chipped rice was given in pure milk, hot milk, and it was there. And then very delicious sweet yogurt was given. You know sandesh? In India, sandesh. Oh, most sweet and not so much sweet, but very delicious and tasteful. Oh, months of that was given. And then, oh, they gave some lips like cup. And thousand more came from all that villages. Those who went to collect all these things, all villagers heard that, oh, there will be festival and thousands came there. And there, oh, it was given. There was no place for thousands of persons. So some stand up in the Ganges, water, some here, here. And then some plates were given for Nityananda Prabhu. He told that bring one plate also, more. And then second plate was given. And same thing like Nityananda Prabhu was given to two dishes. And then he closed, he meditated. And he prayed. And Nityananda Prabhu, all were seeing, Kirtan was going. Mahaprasade Govinde Vaishnave Sarva Punya Vishwasa Naiva Jayate Sariraya Vidya Jadantiya Kaiva Jive Pele Vichara Sagare Armate Jiva Jati ताके जेता कठिन संसारे कृष्ण बड़ा दयामा करिवादे disappeared. So, this is the mercy of Nityananda Prabhu and then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu both. And what became after? The obstacles which were in the way of Raghunath Das Goswami. Nityananda Prabhu told, you have satisfied me, now all problems and obstacles will go away. And very soon, your desire to meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will fulfill. And what became? After some days, they saw that, oh, this boy is mad after Mahaprabhu. They married a very beautiful uni, like Miss Universe. But no attraction, nothing. And very soon he wanted to go. Now one day, it became Jadunanda Nacharjkem that my priest has worshipper of duties has gone anywhere, you should bring. Oh, I will bring, you should go. At about 4 in night, a.m. in night, and what became? Oh, his father, mother, everyone thinking that, oh, he is with Jadunanda Acharya. Where he will go? So, no police and no guards were there. And he went and just, he sent that worshipper, and himself, what he did? At once went to Puri. 1 month way, but he crossed in 12 days only, not eating anything, only some mudi, some madhukri here, then some milk. And in the 12 days he became black, very lean thing. Very dirty. He never took bath or anything, day and night through one. For forest he was, not in fog, otherwise his father will catch hold. And thus he went there. Yes, so see. Then Nityananda Prabhu in mercy, and we want to laugh and to make both. Understand? Understand what I told? Boxing. How it can be? Two swords cannot be in a case. So, we should try to follow Raghunath Das Goswami. Really, if you want devotion, other people. When he reached there, what became? Bolo tum. And I said, you should tell, you know, what became. When he went there, in easy language.
When Raghunath Das Goswami finally arrived at the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave him into the hands of, literally into the hands of Sri Swarup Damodar Goswami. He put his hands in his hands, and now he said, now he is Swarupara Raghu. He is the Raghunath of Swarup Damodar Goswami. And he asked Swarup Damodar to train him in pure bhakti. So Raghunath Das...
Why he could not keep with him? Why he gave his hand in this of Narada? To keep him, he should speak something. Tatami 5 minutes vishram koredi.
Chandra Radhikavi Tadali Krishna Krishna Bhakta Tad Bhakta Namo. So after received the mercy of Lord Chaitanya Nityananda Prabhu, Srila Raghunath Das Goswami Pad, he came and Jagannath Puri and he met with Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That time Chaitanya Mahaprabhu,
he never that time not went to Jagannath temple. He went direct
to meet with Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That time Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu quoted one verse. Krishna Banishta Tumhari Vishay Vrishta Kira Uthilo. Krishna is very powerful and he also delivered to you from. Krishna is very merciful and shall deliver you from the drain, ditch from the ditch. As like one stool of one in the stool and Krishna delivered you. At that time Raghunath Das Goswami in his mind is thinking, Krishna Kripa Nahi Ami Jani. I don't know the mercy of Krishna. I know your mercy. Chaitanya, how his love and affection with Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Actually, Raghunath Das Goswami, who is his real guru? Though external he receives mantra from Jadunandan Acharya, but Raghunath Das Goswami always thinking, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is my guru. And guru also delivered me from the ditch of stone, these things. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that time, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself also offered hand to lotus feet of a lotus hand of Sarup Damodar. Why? Just now Gurudev also asked questions. Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu absorbed in his sweet pastimes and he absorbed in his mood of Srimati Radhika. And he was talking sweet pastimes of Radha and Krishna with Sarup Damodar, Rai Ramananda. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu offered. Here is also
That is the thing, important thing. Krishna cannot help you. Only his associates can help you. What is bhakti and how to serve Krishna, Krishna does not know. Understand? He does not know. So, those who are worshipping, those who are serving Krishna, Mahaprabhu, they can teach anything. So don't go directly to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He will not accept. He told that, I don't know anything. I don't know anything. He knows more better than that. And this was true. Mahaprabhu cannot serve. He can serve only to Radhika. And devotees can serve. Even he was so high class of devotees, Raghunath Das Goswami. So he used to know some modes of Sarup Damodar. We cannot. So we'll have to go to Madhyam Adhikari, sincere Vaishnava, knowing all Shastra. Then they will teach. Rupa Goswami and Sarup Damodar cannot teach you because they are Mahabhagavat. Raya Ramananda cannot do anything here. Even he could not go up Nrisinghananda, Pradyumna Brahmachari too. So don't follow to go to Mahaprabhu direct or Nityananda Prabhu or you should go to Madhyam Adhikari who are nearer to us and they can teach anything.
So that time everybody known to him, Sarupir Raghu. That means he belongs to Sarup Damodar. And Raghunath Das Goswami, how did he maintain his life? Krishna Das Kaviraj explained, Raghunathir Vairagya Jano Pasaner Rekha. Raghunath Goswami is his Vairagya renunciation. If you make one line in the stone, this line never omit. As like Raghunath Das Goswami is his renunciation in Jagannath Puri. As like this. He did not go here and there, and he will be first. He also stay in Jagannath temple, that's called Singha Darbaja. And some person there going and giving some madhukuri. In this way, Raghunath Das Goswami he maintained his life, and 24 hours he absorbed his sadhana and bhajan. Always remember, sometimes he also met with Sarup Damodar and Rai Ramananda because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Always he associated with Sarup Damodar and Rai Ramananda. So, Raghunath Das Goswami, sometimes he comes and meet with Sarup Damodar, and Sarup Damodar also explains about the mood of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. In this way, he also maintained his life. After a few days, then he left that place and he was not staying there. And that time, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked, oh, how did he maintain his life? That in a few days before, he was staying in front of Singha Darbaja and taking some Madhuri, but now he is not. That time he said, Raghunath Das Goswami, why did not it? Raghunath Das Goswami thought, Raghunath Das Goswami, he thought, oh, this is what he has like?
Prostitute.
Oh, he will come, give something, he will come, give something.
Yesterday he gave something, today he will give something.
Yeah. Yesterday will
give,
this is
when,
so
if. Wait, not yesterday. Or after some time, he will give me prasadam. And then person went and he thought that he could not give me. Oh, this person is coming and he will give. In this way, waiting for hours.
So Raghunath Das Goswami, in his mind, he also
rejected.
He rejected these things. How did he maintain his life? Very nice and beautiful Krishna Das Kaviraj explained. In the Jagannath Puri, some prasadas, they are not selling in the market and they also throwing in the drain. Even that the rice are very rotten. Even that the cows cannot take, rejected that. And Raghunath Das Goswami, he took that the rice and washing and taking without salt. One day Sarup Damodar also explained to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. One day Chaitanya, Raghunath Das Goswami was taking that rice, and then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came and so cut his hand and also told, oh, every day you are taking very nice prasadam. Why did not you give me? One, two, then Sarup Damodar also was talked to him, Prabhu, don't you take this. This is not for him. In this way, Raghunath Das Goswami, he maintained his life in Jagannath Puri.
Thank you. I know you are very greedy.
So when Mahaprabhu hand over Raghunath Das Goswami to Sarup Damodar, then he well known as Sarup Raghu, because Mahaprabhu has three Raghunath. One is Bhatta Raghunath, another Vaidya Raghunath, this is Das Raghunath, so Sarup Raghu.
His father used to send money.
And his father came to know that Raghunath is at present in Jagannath Puri. So he sent some servants and some money and for cooking some Brahmin. So Raghunath Das Goswami used to invite Mahaprabhu twice a month. Which money has sent by his father, he used to use that for Mahaprabhu's service and used to take prasad. He maintained his life in this way 2 years. After 2 years, when Raghunath Das Goswami was not inviting anymore to Mahaprabhu, then Mahaprabhu inquired, why Raghunath is not inviting anymore? Then he came to know through Sarup Damodar Prabhu and others that now he is maintaining his life standing on Singha Dwar. You have heard, oh, this man is coming, give me. Oh, he passed away, next must give me. Then he thought, Singha Dware Bhiksha Vritti Vesha Vyavahar. Standing on Singha Dwar, the main gate, the eastern gate of Jagannath Puri, if I stay there hours and hours, it's not good. So he gave it up. Since profession last, this is the occupation like a prostitute.
Why he was not inviting now Mahaprabhu?
So why Das Goswami is not inviting Mahaprabhu? So because one day Mahaprabhu told, Bishoyi anna khaile molin hoy mon, molin mon hoile nahe Krishna rasmaran. Because his father was Vaishnava Braj. So he always maintained his Vishay, means his land, property. So if you take any grain from them, then your mind will be polluted like him. And if mind will be polluted, you could not remember Krishna properly. Just like Gurudev has given example so many times. In Mahabharata battle, when Bhishma Pitamaha was lying on arrow bed, and all Pancha Pandavas, they thought we shall give up our life, we kill so many relatives. Even Krishna could not make them understand. Then Krishna took to Bhishma Pitamaha. Then Bhishma Pitamaha gave them some instruction. Then Draupadi began to smile. Then grandfather Bhishma Pitamaha asked, "Oh Draupadi, why you are smiling?" Draupadi told, "When my cloth was snatching by Dushasan, where was at that time your advice? Where was at that time your intelligent?
Knowledge.
Where is at that time your knowledge?" Then Bhishma Pitamaha told, "At that time I used to take grain from Duryodhan. So my mind was intelligent, was knowledge was polluted. So now I am lying on arrow bed, all blood, everything had gone. So no more is there. So now my mind is free. Intelligence is pure. Knowledge is pure. Similarly, if we do all these things with a sensential person, then our mind will be polluted. If mind polluted, we could not remember Krishna properly." So Srila Rupa Goswami Pada has told, "Dadadi prati grinnati guijam akhati prichati bhumte bhajyata chaiva saravidha priti lakshanam." Dadadi to give, prati grinnati to accept something from them, guijam akhati prichati to open his heart, your heart, and reveal his heart, and to feed him and to eat by him. If this six exchange you will do with any sensual person, then your mind, your inclination, your propensity bound to go to them. And if you do these six exchanges with the devotees, then your devotional activity will increase. So Raghunatha Das Goswami, thinking this, he gave it up. "Oh, I should not take anything more from my father, because he's Vishayi. Then my mind will be polluted. I could not do Krishna bhajan properly, so he gave it up. Then came to Singhadwar, and he gave it up there also. So, Swarup Damodar Prabhu used to go to Mahaprabhu along with Raya Ramananda Prabhu and used to listen to so many things from Mahaprabhu. Das Goswami always keep acting whole night. When Swarup Damodar Prabhu will come, I shall listen what is discussion today. Whenever he used to come, he asked, "Oh Prabhu, what was the subject matter today?" Very humbly requesting him. And Swarup Damodar Prabhu used to tell him, narrate him properly. And he used to write down in his note. And later on, it by the causeless mercy of Raghunatha Das Goswami, Srila Kaviraj Goswami composed Chaitanya Charitamritam. This is the main contents form of Swarup Damodar Prabhu. What was written by Das Goswami, later on Das Goswami offered to Vishnudas Kaviraj Goswami. And nowadays we are seeing Chaitanya Charitamritam form. So one day, Das Goswami asked to Swarup Damodar Prabhu, "I want to listen something from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu." But he's very shy. He never came face to face to Mahaprabhu ask anything. And Antare Radha Krishna Manasya Karibar Bhalana Khai Vyar Bhalana Paribe Amani Manada Haya Krishna Nam Sadalave Braje Radha Krishna Seva Manasya Karibe. So Sadha Sadhan Tattva, Sadha means goal. You have to fix your goal at first. Then have to adopt means and process. If you don't know what is your goal, then how you can adopt the process? So you have to fix your goal at first. What you want to do? See, if you want to go from here India, then if you take any flight from America, you could not arrive there. So you have to fix your goal first. What do you want? And for achieve that goal, you have to adopt some process. So Mahaprabhu told, "You ask from him. He knows better than me." Why? Because Mahaprabhu's Vishaya Tattva and Swarup Damodar Prabhu Ashraya Tattva. So you can know from Vaishnava Dasam Shiva, he told, अहं व्यक्ति सु अहं व्यक्ति सुख व्यक्ति व्यासो व्यक्ति न व्यक्ति वा भक्ता भागवतं राज्यम न बुद्धा न चटीकया टीचर्स शिवजी आई नो एंड सुखदेव गोस्वामी नोस व्यास मे नो और नॉट व्हाई व्यासो नारायण स्वयं विषय तत्व सो वी हैव टू गो आश्रय तत्व स्वरूप दामोदर प्रभु इज आश्रय तत्व सो ही नोज बेटर देन मी सो यू गो टू हिम एंड भलो ना खाइबे आर भलो ना परिबे
स्टिल आई एम टेलिंग समथिंग इफ यू
लाइक आई एम टेलिंग समथिंग इफ यू हैव फेथ ऑन मी सो आई एम टेलिंग समथिंग स्टिल टू यू डोंट ईट पैलेटेबल फूड स्टफ एंड डोंट ड्रेस यू लाइक ए रॉयल ड्रेस एंड अमानी मानद हो कृष्ण नाम सदा लोभे डोंट हैंकरिंग फॉर योर ओन प्रेज and try to respect everyone according to their gradation. Moreover, Braje Radha Krishna Seva Manase Karibe, and you will serve divine couple in Braj by your mind. How come?
Kashtakaliya Leela.
How come? That Krishna's eightfolded pastimes, we have to serve accordingly. Like you have heard from Gurudev and other Vaishnavas, once Dasgosami, in his last stage, he made some preparation by his mind and offered to divine couple. After that, he took some remnant. At that time, he used to maintain his life only by some buttermilk, little bit buttermilk. And his stomach was became upset. Then Ayurvedic doctor came and filled his pulse. He told so much grain, rice inside his stomach. All Brajavasis said, how come? Oh, Ayurvedic doctor, are you mad? Well, no, I am not mad. You can ask him. Some indigestion, so many grains are they over it today? Then they asked, well, yes. How come? Well, I cooked some sweet rice, offered to divine couple. After this remnant was left over from them, I eat too much sweet rice by mind, not by direct. So in the same way, have to serve divine couple in Ashtakaliya Leela. And Gramma Patha na bolibe, Gramma Patha na sunibe. Don't talk mundane talk and don't listen mundane talk. If you be free from mundane talk and you be Amani Mano, then you can develop your Krishna consciousness very easily. By this way, Das Goswami was advancing in Krishna consciousness under guidance of Swarup Damodar Prabhu and always following Mahaprabhu's advice through Swarup Damodar Prabhu. So if you direct to serve Krishna, you could not get any perfection. It's mentioned in scripture, Siddhir Bhavati Baneti Samsachita Sevinam Nisamsas Tadbhakta Paricharya Ratatmanam.
Explain briefly.
So
don't
if you
go out of subject.
If you serve Krishna directly, you may get perfection or not. But if you serve his devotee, then perfection in your feast, inside your feast. Similarly, Das Goswami is not approaching Mahaprabhu directly, everything through Swarup Damodar, under his guidance. So if we do everything under guidance of bona fide Gurudev and Vaishnavas, then our life will be successful, then you can advance in Krishna consciousness. One day will come, then you can follow Das Goswami, and we can serve Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and divine couple like himself under guidance of Gurudev. Hare Krishna. Pancha Kalpataru Bhastya Kripa Sindhu Bhaya Vacha Kaitanam Pravane Bho Vishwale.
This was the last instruction of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Bhalo na khaibe, bhalo na paribe, amani manu dhaye Krishna naam sada bebe. Gramme katha na sunibe, na gramme katha ना बोलिबे अमानी मानद भये कृष्ण नाम सदा लेबे एंड देन अंतरे मानव सेवा मैन दिस ही हैज एक्सप्लेन ऑल दिस थिंग डोंट टेक रिच फूड रिच एंड डेलिशियस फूड इफ इट इज नॉट फाउंड इन मट ओह देन वी विल गो टू रेस्टोरेंट or any devotee's house, don't go. Then your bhakti will go away. भालू ना खाइबे ना करिबे डोंट टेक ऑफ व्हाट ब्यूटीफुल गार्मेंट्स फैशनेबल थिंग्स डोंट also don't criticize anyone especially Vaishnav and you should be man other give proper respect to other but don't hankering from all these things and inside always serving Krishna in the process that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to do, Rupa Goswami and all other Goswami. And he followed totally. After some day, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu disappeared from this world. Later on, Gadadhar Pandit, Sarup Damodar, Raya Ramananda, all disappeared. Then he began to weep. And he wanted to give up his life in separation. But anyhow, he wanted to come to Vrindavan because gradually all Vaishnavas in Puri after Chaitanya Mahaprabhu left and they some returned back to Mayapur, Navadvip, some to Vrindavan, some here and there. So that place was like a ghost place. At that time, after Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So, he wanted also to die. But I will die in Vrindavan, in Jamuna, jumping or from Govardhan, jumping. He came. But Rup Sanatan, he first met with Rup Sanatan. They were like their elder brother or father. He used to know this Chaitanya Mahaprabhu how giving honor to Sanatan Goswami and how he has love and affection for him. When he went there, he was about to die, not taking anything. And then pacified him. If by dying Krishna will meet, then Sanatana Goswami told that I was going to die, but Mahaprabhu himself said, don't try to do. Be seated in Radha Kunda. There we will make some hut for you. Time to time we will go to you. And you should be there like you were in Puri, fixed place. And there you should do your sadhana. Then he went there and they went there and made a place for him. And what he was doing? 24 hours doing bhajan. In the morning he used to do pranam for all the Vaishnav, all the sacred places of Vrindavan, all Kunjir, Mother Yashoda, Nanda Baba, the associates of Radhika, Lalita, Vishakha, Chitra, Champa, Lata. All more than thousands of dandavat pranam. And weeping, rolling down, he Radhe, Braj Devi ke chalite he Nanda Sudha. Oh Krishna, where you are? Oh Lalite, oh Vishakhe, where you are? What taking? Nothing, as he told. Only some buttermilk. Nothing. And very small. Nothing else. And day and night weeping. After that, Rup Goswami saw that he is so much weeping and feeling separation. Then he gave him Vidagdha Madhava to read. And he became like mad, weeping, and book was waiting and destroying. Then Rupa Goswami told that you should give, I will have to correct something. I will not give him. Then he wrote for him only, Dan Keli Komudi. How Krishna checked all the gopis in Dan Ghati. and they were quarreling each other. And Krishna wanted some toll tax. And they were telling him, oh, this ghati is of your father or from where you have. And so many struggles were there. Yatraiva Krishna Vishabhanu Putra Danam Grihitum Kalaham Viti Sutesh Pihajat Mahattatah Sri Govardhano Me. Oh, what telling? Oh, Giraj, you have seen how they were quarreling. Krishna was wanting some toll tax and they were there. Oh, this is a Vrindavaneshwari Radha, not your forefathers. Vrinda has donated this estate, whole estate to Vrindadeva. Krishna told that Vrinda is my wife, his property is mine. Oh, they called Vrinda. Oh, are you married wife of Krishna? Oh, I don't know this black cheater. He thinks that all Vrajavasi, all gopis are his wife. So, this thing. So, I want to hear. The Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, he is telling like this. I want to be in Vrindavan, in the dust of Giriraj Govardhan, that he is to be. So, Raghunath Das Goswami. So, he gave and he began to laugh sometimes, all rolling down and laughing. Then, very cleverly, trickily, Rupa Goswami told the, oh, that Vidak Madhav you should give for some days, I will correct. And he took. So, he was always mad, like, always engaged. And he has written what, you know, after some time, he was doing bhajan in this way. He wrote Bilap Kushmanjali. And he is doing pranam to his guru. Who is guru? Not guru is Sarva Damodar here. Really, his guru, to whom he is following. Who is that? Rupmanjari. Prathita Apureshme. Oh, Rupmanjari, he is doing pranam to his guru. Oh, Rupmanjari. Not pranam, like joke, he is telling. Oh, you are very famous in this whole Braj, that you are very less chaste lady. But your husband is not in home. He has gone to buy cow or to anyhow, outside for so many days. But I see that, here is some how it become? It seems that any parrot has come and he thought that it is some fruit. So he has cut on perhaps. How? So he did pranam and then he began Vishpan Bilap Kushma. He told that. He did pranam to his Siksha Guru also, Sanatana Goswami. Vairagya Yoga Bhakti Rasam Prayatna Yapayan Manun Vipshamanda Kripam Mudirja Paradukha Dukhi Sanatanastam Prabhu Master. I am doing pranam to Sanatana Goswami. He was very kind to me. Weeping, weeping, weeping. I never wanted to take this. The nectar of Krishna pastimes. I never. And he gave it forcibly. So he was so merciful. I never wanted mercy. But he forcibly gave me. So I am doing pranam. Tavai vasmi. Tavai vasmi. Najivami tvaya vina. Iti vigyaye radhe. Tangnay maam charana. O radhe. You are only mine. You are only mine and you are only mine. Without, I will give up my body at once. I want to sir, like Sakhi, Lalita Vishakha, Padabjoyostava Bina Paradasyamiva, Nannat Kadapi Samayi Kili Dehi Jache, Sakhyayate Mama Namastu Namastu Nityam Dasyayate. I don't want to be Sakhi of Radhika, like Lalita Vishakha, equal rank. I want what? Oh, you should give me this one. Oh, Radhike, my Swamini Ji, I want to serve you. Like, in the guidance of Rup Manjari, your most obedient and most dear maid servant. Sri Rupa Manjari Karachita Pada Padma, Goshrenda Nandana Bhujarpita Mastikaya, Hamodata Kanak Gaur Padari Vinde, Sambana Nisana Kaiste. This is the Rupa Nudhara. He said, oh Rup Manjari, you only can save me by your remnant. How? Once Srimati Radhika was lying down on the left, and Krishna was caressing her heads and serving, and his feet were in the lap of Rup Manjari, and he was very gently. Then Rup Manjari, called Rati Manjari, Raghunath Das Goswami, come on, I will give you remnant. And he said, you should massage the hand, I will fan. How their Rup Manjari is merciful, she gets this remnant. I'm telling all these things that, this is our aim and object. And how received the Raghunath Das? If you are not that, like him, how you can? He has told, Asa bharai amrit sindh mayai katanchit, kalo mayati gamita akila samtami, tanchit.